are not yet where we need to be on several of the most difficult issues. And the truth is that while I completely agree with Foreign Minister Zarif that we have never been closer, at this point, this negotiation could go either way.
Yeah, all right. Well, and the president earlier today said that it's about 50-50, which I guess is translated to either way. Jed Babin, Washington Times columnist, former deputy undersecretary of defense for President George H.W. Bush, and author of The BDS War Against Israel. There it is on your screen. Jed, great to talk to you again. So, I believe me, we're both in the same boat on this this Iran deal thing. But are you a little surprised, pleasantly maybe, that things aren't going so well, or is this a smokescreen of some sort?
Oh, I think it's a big smokescreen, Stephen. Again, it's great to be with you, as always. I think we're going to have this thing go on and on and on. I don't think Kerry and Obama are ever going to cut it off until the Iranians come to the table and say, okay, we're ready to make a deal. And time's on their side, not on ours. We're tying everything up right now. It's just not going to work. And I'll tell you, and I think we've said this before, I think I said this before on this show, there will be no peaceful dissolution of the Iranian nuclear weapons program. In order to take out that program, we're going to have to literally take it out by military means. There's no compromise with these guys.
No, well, I couldn't agree with you more. But interesting, I mean, let's figure that Iran is insisting on all kinds of immediate sanctions relief, which that's no secret, and they're limiting to a very severely, inspections, no surprise inspections, whatever, number of centrifuges, everything that goes against what the Obama administration early on had demanded, quote-unquote demanded. So let's say, you know, they all go home at the end of the week, because then they're nowhere. So then they just, you know, arrange a new date to meet like in a month or two and to start over again or continue?
Yeah, of course. I mean, they're not going to walk away because Obama needs this deal for his legacy, although he doesn't need it for America's sake, God knows. But he's going to keep at it again and again and again. And I think this could go on for another year before you see a real reaching of a deal. And when the deal comes, whenever it comes, if it comes tomorrow, if it comes a year from now, it's going to be very bad for us, for our allies, and for our national security.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely right. Whatever happens, it's not a good situation, and it's going to get a lot worse. You wrote a great piece, the Iran deal and the happy terrorists. Explain what you mean.
Well, the point really comes down to, at the time when we're diddling along with Iran and they're playing us like a cheap fiddle, we're also giving the Iranians and the rest of the terrorist world a big bonus. I mean, on the ISIS anniversary, or within a few days of the ISIS founding, the anniversary of it, Obama said, well, we're lifting the rule, which of course is an American law that you can't lift, to say that American hostages and their families can pay ransom for their release. Now, that's been a policy of ours going back to, I don't know, Thomas Jefferson, give or take, 1805, when we sent the Marines in to fight the Tripolitan pirates. And, you know, this has been going on forever. It's a simple market principle, Steve. You know, when you subsidize something by, say, giving ransoms to terrorists, you get more of it. When you penalize it, you get less. And that's the fact of this policy. That's the whole reason for it. We're now going to see Americans taken hostage in a lot more places.
Absolutely.
A lot more groups because of this new change.
Couldn't agree with you more. The FBI Director Comey yesterday testifying before Congress, talking about keeping the homeland safe from ISIS, really specifically, and their influence, lone wolves or whatever you want to call them, surrogates here in the United States. He basically said, I'm overwhelmed. We're overwhelmed. We've been really diligent and lucky so far and good, but I don't think we could keep it up. That's basically what he said.
Well, it's not surprising. I mean, in truth, the FBI has been doing a pretty terrific job of getting these guys before they can strike, and that's not going to continue forever. It just simply can't. I mean, they're real good, but the law of averages is on the side of the terrorists, and some of these events that we've seen in other countries are going to happen here. And what's going to happen if someone seizes a shopping mall and we see a video of American shoppers being beheaded by ISIS? I think we really need to take this a lot more seriously. Obama has not. We've got now Ashton Carter yesterday talking about how we've got 60 60.
Can you imagine that? Syrian fighters trained 60.
Yeah, well, they're not even trained yet. I mean, those are the guys that are still in training. We had 90, but it's 30 of them left. I mean, this is a joke, Steve. It's a horrible joke. It's a sad joke. It's a tragic joke.
It is. And when Marie Harf and Barack Obama find jobs for all these people, then the terrorism problem will end. Jed, great to talk to you, sir. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
All right, Jed Babin, ladies and gentlemen. It is just a horror show, and it's waiting to get much, much worse. All right, up next, marketing director for a media group that talks all about China and the influence of the Chinese government on media, and I think you're going to find that very interesting when we come back. But right now, Newsmax wants to send one lucky couple on a 7-day Silver Sea cruise. To do that, you have to register. Go to newsmax.com/sweepstakes, and good luck.